Welcome, guys. I'm Louis the Panda, one of the casters for the SBO. Today, I'm joined by Rin Forsando, who is the winner of the February Open Cup. How's it going, Forsando? How are you feeling, man?
I'm great. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you for taking your time to do this interview for me. I think a lot of people saw you put in a great performance, and we just want to know a little bit more about you. So my first questions I want to ask you, was this your first SBO? Have you played in the past?
I played some SVO in the past. I think it's my third SVO. I played one SVO last season, and yeah, one in 2017. So it was a bit far away from the last two SVO.
Okay, so you've played in the past. But this time, not only did you get to top 8, but you won the entire event. What do you think was the difference this time around?
I don't know. Perhaps I was more motivated. And I was a bit lucky too, I think.
Okay. Can you tell me a little bit about your lineup? One of the things to me that stood out as a commentator was that we saw a lot of Luxus Forestcraft players, but you were one of the players playing Axel Forestcraft instead. Can you tell me what was your decision there? Why did you choose to bring the Axel Forest instead?
So basically, I was playing a lot of Axel Forest in ladder, and I was very confident with it. Luxus Forest is a very, it's very hard to play it correctly, and yeah, I wasn't confident with it, so I decided to take Axel Forest instead of Luxus Forest.
Yeah, well, it was a great choice because you won the entire event. The other deck that I want to talk about is the Aggro Shadow. I feel like from our perspective, watching you, it was mainly like the Aggro Shadow show. Like, you were that deck, you piloted so well, you went first so much, like it was just a force to reckon with. Can you tell me a little bit about your place with the Aggro Shadowcraft?
I must admit that I was very lucky because during the top 8, I think I was only second one time with the Aggro Shadow, and every other time I was first. So yeah, it helped a lot. And yeah, it's not a very skillful deck. You just play it a bit YOLO and yeah.
I mean, you know, it's easy to say that, like, yeah, you went first and it's not the complicated deck, but I think you played well. You know, you won. You defeated a player of Noir's caliber. How did you feel going up into the finals against them? And then how did you feel after to have beaten such a, you know, the top player of the Shadowverse Open?
So basically, when I made to top 8, I couldn't believe it. I was so excited. And yeah, I made, for me, it was, even if I lost my first match, it doesn't matter. I made a great tournament. But after winning top 8, top 4, and the final match, I was very happy during the final vs Noir. I know him a bit because I watched last SVO, and he's very consistent. He made to top 8 basically each SVO. So for me, it was the big boss of the SVO.
Yeah. So you won the February SBO, which is the first SBO. That means that you are now the number one player in the standings. You have the most points. You have a nice lead into the future. I assume you're going to play in the March SBO. Can you tell me how you feel now that you are no longer that unknown player, but now you stand as the number one in the leaderboards?
At the moment, I don't feel different. Basically, I mean, that's great. I won the last SVO, but I need to be consistent now. And for the next SVO, if I make 5-2, it will be good, a good result. I know it will be very difficult to make to top 8 again, but I will try.
Hey, I mean, you won once, it could happen again, right? And I like your mindset because you have the point lead, just a 5-2 scoreline. If you can maintain that for a couple months, then you will likely qualify for the Contenders Cup. Have you thought about making it to Contenders, potentially going to Worlds? What would that mean for you?
Yes, basically, me and a friend, we decided to play every SVO this year. And even if we are down 1-3, we continue to make, 4-3 or 5-2, just to make some points. And we calculated if we need to make at least 5 points each SVO to qualify to the top 8. So, I think now I have 11 points. So I have a good lead. I can do even some 4-3. It will be good for the Contenders Cup.
Are you thinking about the World Championship or just focusing on Contenders for now?
No, now I'm just focusing on the Contenders Cup.
Okay, that's nice. On the broadcast, we get to see you for the first time. You showed off a bit of your personality. Can you tell me about you as a person? Like, are you a student? Do you work? What kind of interests do you like? What kind of a person are you?
I'm a student at university. I'm studying math. It's my third year now. And yeah, I like math, video games, and music, classical music.
Okay, well, I want to thank you so much for taking your time to this interview with me. I really appreciate you doing this. I hope we get to see more of you in the Shadowverse Open, whether it be in the top 8 or just up there in the standings. Again, thank you so much, Rinforzando. Any final words you want to say? Anything to your fans, anybody supporting you or anything like that?
A big shout out to my friend, Chris. He helped me a lot during the SVO. I mean, between the match, he helped me with matchup, which ban I need to take. And I don't think I would win the SVO without him. So big shout out to him.
Okay, well, again, thank you so much for doing this. And I hope we'll see you in the future. Goodbye.
Goodbye.